devices are not on the exchanges, and they're just like in like a weird wallet space. Not super familiar with that stuff. Coinbase is always adding new stuff. There's some stuff that's tradable, there's some stuff that isn't. But you know, let's start with the Bitcoin, you know, the original. So Bitcoin was the world's first cryptocurrency. Bitcoin is stored in exchange securely on the internet through a digital ledger known as a blockchain. Bitcoins are divisible into smaller units known as satoshis. Each satoshi is worth 0.00000001 Bitcoin. Currently, 389.3 billion market cap, which is extremely low compared to when it was at an all-time high of 68,000. I believe that the market cap at one point was 800 billion or 900 billion. It might even have been 1 trillion. That was at peak, and I was not looking because I was very, very upset that I had sold Bitcoin that I had previously purchased in 2016, 17, when Ripple first came out. I bought a bunch of Bitcoin to buy Ripple, which ended up just falling apart and dying. So that was unsuccessful, like most of my investments, but that's alright, because we're going to keep going with that. Currently, the last 24 hours, it's been like all buying activity on Coinbase, so that's pretty bullish, but it doesn't seem like, in the grand scheme of things, Bitcoin is really going to be going up anytime soon. I'm pretty sure we're just going to stay in this $19,000 to $23,000 channel. I could be wrong. That seems like what everyone is saying. That's what the charts are looking like. It could squeeze, it could tank, whatever, you know. Let's see, I'm gonna check on a couple other things that I own. So I have some ETH 2.0 locked away, currently sitting at $1,166.66. I would love to see a bullish uptrend to this as the rollout of Ethereum 2.0 comes. Because I'm pretty sure once Ethereum 2 launches, the asset becomes deflationary instead of inflationary. I'm hoping that once ETH 2.0, it won't be a buy the rumor, sell the news type, or, you know, that type of thing where, like, it tanks once it completely comes out, you know. Also, a lot of people have all of their ETH locked up, so, you know, there could be people sitting on millions of dollars. That's now $500,000 or less because of how much it's dropped, and they might want to just get out once their Ethereum unlocks, so that could tank it, you know. But it also could be super bullish. I don't really know, because who knows, once ETH 2.0 drops, the percentage rate could go up. It could be 10%, 15% APR, you know. I don't know exactly what is going to happen or where this is going. I know nothing. Alright, XRP. You know, I thought once there was the thing with the SEC, that this was gonna go up, but it has not, and you still can't trade it on Coinbase, which is very annoying. Wow, only a 16 billion market cap, that's crazy. I wonder. Yep. So, let's see. Around right here is where I purchased it. You know, in this 20 to 40 cent channel. And then this is where I held it and thought I was going to be a millionaire with, I don't know, $1,000, $2,000 worth of Ripple that I had purchased that was, you know, a couple grand once it hit peak. And then boom, tanked. And I'm still holding that XRP to this day, because I refuse to sell anything at a loss, and that's why I'm down like 70% on my AMC. Yawns. I'm a big fan of Elk. I'm a big fan of Algorand. Where are we? Algorand. Oh, 95% buy rating. That's pretty good. So I bought Algo around 30 cents, 20, 30 cents in this channel here before the first run up. And I remember buying it early on in this 30 cent channel. So I just kept buying it. Went all the way. I remember sitting in my bed. It was like 3 a.m. when this happened right here. And it says 7 p.m. there, but I know it was 3 a.m. I literally watched it 282. It was between 2 and 3 a.m. And oh my gosh, I was like, I am gonna be rich. And then bam, falling off. And then, you know, I had around like, $3,000 or $4,000 algo. And I ended up selling it back once it dropped, you know, to like my buy-in. I didn't go negative on that, but I probably, you know, I definitely regret selling it, not selling here, you know. I didn't hold things way too long. Because I was like, oh, you know, I got $3,000 or $4,000 algo, you know, which really only cost me like $1,000. And right here, I was like, oh, if this thing goes to $10, $20, you know, I could have thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars, you know. But, you know, that was before I knew a lot about market cap and the grand scheme of things. So, you know, that's when I lost a lot of money. Let's look at something I have never looked at before. BitTorrent new. I used to have BTT. I have a bunch of crypto I can't get off of Binance because I can't get into my account because it's not allowed in my state anymore. When it was like completely unregulated, that's how I ended up buying Bitcoin, then transferring it to buying Bitcoin on Coinbase, sending to my Binance wallet, and then bought Ripple and sent it to my Coinbase wallet, something like that. It was like this, it used to be so difficult to buy Bitcoin. I remember you had to go through, it took like a week to get to buy Bitcoin. You know, the first time you had to get verified and all this stuff. It's not like how it is today. Now it's just like, you know, super centralized and this and that. And, you know, I thought it was probably was better back then, you know. But like, you know, Bitcoin was only $1,800 then, or $2,000 then. Like when I bought Ripple, I was like, it's disgusting how much Bitcoin I had, you know. It would have been worth like 60 grand or 50 grand, you know, when Bitcoin hit its all-time high, which, you know, was pretty depressing for me, because, you know, when Bitcoin was up, man, I was not doing well. let's see. PancakeSwap. This is something I've never looked into. I know quite a few people that use this, or like have PancakeSwap. What is the cake? Let's see what this is. Oh, it doesn't actually give me any display of what it is. Okay, all right. I guess we'll go to a different one. This is something that's never gonna go above like 5-6 cents, I think. I have a bunch of this in my first wallet that I can't access. Let's see. Why does it only go back? Okay, alright. So I bought it maybe around, it was 2018, maybe then, 2017. Yeah, I bought it when it was real low. It was on his TRX, yeah, TRX. I bought it on Binance. A little bit of stuff, and I swear it just stayed the same, but I guess maybe I just didn't have enough of it, or I don't know. But there's a lot of Tron in circulation. lost an Ethereum token that powers Marlin. I wonder what's going to happen to all these Ethereum tokens when ETH 2.0 launches, because Ethereum 2.0 is supposed to fix all the issues of Ethereum. So all these ETH tokens are doing this and that and this and that. Either they're going to get really scalable and really efficient along with it because they're Ethereum tokens, or I don't know. I really don't understand what's going to. 1 million bond can also be used to mint 1 M bond. Okay, so that now you become a voter on Futures of the Network. That's pretty cool, I guess. What else? Oh, yeah, I saw this was trending on StockTwits, Jasmine. There's just so much bullshit in here, though. These are like 99% of these are all bullshit, in my opinion. But, you know, I don't want to be that guy, but most of them are just all going to go to zero at some point, in my opinion. You know, that or they're just going to be propped up by bullshit. Let's see the losers. Ooh, down 23%. What have been... Oh yeah, Voyager's been taking hits for the past couple days. I guess they're limiting. I used to have a bunch of money on Voyager. I'm very happy I got rid of it. Yeah, wow. This is when I would have bought it around here if I was going to buy it, because I remember this is around the time, 2021, when I was on Voyager a lot. I was buying like StormX, STMX. Let's see, STMX. If they're even on here. Oh, they are on here. Oh, wow, yeah, StormX is doing pretty bad, too. Yeah, this interesting token. You get rewards by using. This is actually pretty cool. So StormX is like. It's a token or a coin that when you purchase things on their app, you get rewards back in StormX, and you get like smart upwards of like 20%, 30% sometimes. Like, look, let's see. Up to 87%. That's pretty cool. Like, if you bought this thing on eBay, you'd earn $8 in their crypto. It's like pretty, it's actually pretty like solid. But I guess the owner Simon is not, see, like, they've given out $5 million in rewards. I guess the owner Simon's kind of like runs around like circles though, and like, I mean, these are like big companies to be spawned, like be able to like on, you know. But apparently Simon is not like a man of his word, and like, I'm in the Discord, and there was supposed to be a debit card like over a year ago or 2 years ago where like you'd spend money online or in person and you would get a percentage back based on that, you know, like a flat rate or something, and it never seemed to come out. So whatever, there's nothing I can do about that, but it looks like it's probably gonna, you know, go a little further down with the market if the market continues to go down. This channel right here was like, wow, this was like an interesting time in crypto. What was Bitcoin doing at this time between 2018 and 2021? Because that's when I stepped away from crypto. Yeah, so like, this is the time where like I was like, it's probably dead, it's probably like not coming back. So like, here's where like I got into Ripple, something like this. Here's where I was like, yeah, this is probably BS. Because I lost money. I lost money over here and everything was coming down. And then around maybe here, I started buying an algo. Or maybe here, I started buying an algo somewhere around here. You know, I don't remember the dates perfectly, but you know, at some point in here, I started buying back in. But I was so upset, and I thought Bitcoin was going to go to zero and all these things, and I just didn't know a lot, and I still